Operating spotlight throws back to October of 2022. We catch the local LWN-01 getting ready to depart Naptown Yard for the West Naptown site. Power today is a pair of INDOT GP38-2s, number 3802 and 3806. Municipal road crews have been hard at work patching and repaving the roads in and around West Nap trackage, including a number of crossings and paved over sidings. And as a result of this work and in revoke and curfews, there is a significant backlog of freight ready to move into the local industries. Our crew will have their work cut out for them. There will be no interfering traffic this day, but staged empty coal hoppers are blocking the primary runaround, and the crew will have to make several moves to juggle everything. A construction curfew will take effect before an inbound coal train can get back there, so the local will bring the empty coal hoppers back to the yard. The local will pass between several large factories, including an empty repair hall for the railroad, before entering the yard limits. To our left, the towering concrete monolith of Acme Evans Green welcomes us to the worksite, but the crew will have to go all the way down in order to yard their mammoth consist. Besides Acme Evans, there exists an IPL steam tank, which still receives coal for now. There is also a cold storage warehouse, which sits on the old right-of-way where it turned and rose to meet the Belt Railroad, a ball glass factory, multiple hardware and equipment manufacturers which ship out finished product, Naptown Club and Textiles, a Wonder Bread Bakery, and Great Run Sugar. West Naptown is one of the oldest sections both of the fictional NWR and of the physical layout, and is likely one of the least changed from its original construction. It was part of the original mainline before the club punched the staging yard tunnel into the new crew room, severing West Naptown at Ball Glass. Likewise, the West Naptown could depict a partially abandoned segment of the Naptown River on the west side of Indianapolis. In the late 1800s, it was a part of the Indianapolis, Cincinnati, and Lafayette Railroad. But urban expansion and an increase in through traffic saw most trains diverted onto the Indianapolis Union or Belt Railway. As a result, the West Naptown was severed at the junction with the Belt and became a dead-end industrial district. The West Nap territory starts in the forgotten community of Ratcliffe behind the Roundhouse. Once a small corner burb, like so many neighborhoods in Indianapolis, Ratcliffe is now all but indistinguishable from the rest of the urban footprint. Only the name, printed across the top of GIS and historical maps over several square blocks and a few fading street signs, indicate the lineage. After getting enough headroom to maneuver, the pair of 38s will shove the entire line of grain hoppers into Acme Evans. Were that siding full, this whole day would likely be next to impossible. Next, the crew is going to stage some of the unneeded boxcars on the old main, using the crossover in front of us. Afterward, they will swing up into the pocket track to spot cars at Naptown Glove and Great Lump Sugar. You can see where the road crews are staged with their dump trucks and bulldozers nervously close to the track. Before leaving this area, the crew is going to remove and reposition a boxcar and gondola from Van Camp LWN-01. To do this, it's going to require several back and forth seesaw motions. There's no room to stage the outbound train yet, so for now they will park them on the pocket track they just used. The three cars behind the engine will go into that siding at three different spots, but it's going to be easier to deal with the last two boxcars first. So the local is going to have to pull them up and use a smaller runaround to get behind them. But before they can do that, they need to remove the remaining empty coal hoppers from the Ratcliffe steam plant. Normally, swapping coal hoppers is the job of a dedicated unit coal train out of a mine in southern Indiana. But again, with road construction and track curfews, the NWR must do as much as it can with the crew it already has on site. With the rest of the coal hoppers pulled out of the steam generating plant, the local crew will now push these onto the string sitting in front of Acme Evans' grain elevator. The entire string will then be shoved further back to clear the switch for the runaround to finish spotting the box cars. It's a good thing this is the only crew with authorization to work in West Naptown, as they will be severely fouling the main switch. Now the crew can get behind their train. There's not enough headroom to switch all five boxcars at once, so the crew pushes the first three up clear of the crossing, and will take the last two to be switched first. The yellow rail box will go to all glass. Thank you. sometimes called a doghouse. The little wooden shed near the tracks once served as a shelter for workers in nearby factories, who were initially, up until about the early 1900s, shuttled in by rail, and then by bus, by the Indianapolis Street Railway up until about the 1950s. Now the surviving examples are mostly homes for the homeless, or for workers to smoke in out of the wind. The low front was to help block the wind from getting inside, but is somewhat inconvenient for taller guests who have to duck under. It's also very hard to see into or out of them to know if a train is coming or if somebody is waiting for a train. With no other outbounds to pull, the local was going to pull up the coal hoppers from earlier and get behind them, pushing them up to retrieve the empty box and gone. Then it's the long, slow ways back to the yard. you have enjoyed this real fan perspective view of operations on the Naptown and Riverbound Railroad. If you are interested in coming and seeing us, visitor nights are on the first Monday and now the second Friday of each month from about 6:30 to 9:30 p.m. We also encourage you to reach out and contact us to arrange a private appointment if you are not available on those dates. We are always accepting members. For more information, please visit naptownrr.org or facebook.com/naptownrr. For more updates on what's going on in, around, and with the club. Thank you very much for watching.